Now have a look at those long, slender fingers. Almost tempts you to sing a song called Click Go the Shears, doesn't it? Just a little more. Let's finish him, hey, so we can see how it all winds up.
There was movement at the station, for the word had passed around that the colt from old regret had got away and had joined the wild bush horses. He was worth £1,000, so all the cracks had gathered to the fray. All the tried and noted riders from the stations near and far had mustered at the homestead overnight. For the bushmen love hard riding where the wild bush horses are, and the stock horse snuffed the battle with delight. He hails from Snowy River up by Kosciuszko's side, where the hills are twice as steep and twice as rough, where a horse of hoof strike by light from the flintstones every stride. The man that holds his own is good enough. And the Snowy River riders on the mountains make their home, where the river runs those giant hills between. I have seen full many horsemen since I first commenced to roam, but nowhere yet such horsemen have I seen.
And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand, no better horseman ever held the rein. And not a horse that's growing while the saddle just sits stand, he learned to ride while droven on the plain.
So Clancy rode to wheel them, he was racing on the wing, where the best and boldest riders take their place. And he raced his stock horse past them, and he made the rangers ring with a stock whip as he met them face to face. Then they halted for a moment as he swung the dreaded lash, and they saw their well-loved mountain full in view. And they charged beneath the stock whip with a sharp and sudden dash, and up into the mountain scrub they flew.
And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand, no better horseman ever held the rein. And not a horse was throwing while the saddle just would stand, he learned to ride while droving on the plain.
When they reached the mountain summit, even Clancy took a pull. It might well make the boldest hold their breath. The wild scrub grew thickly and the hidden ground was full of wombat holes, and any slip was death. But the man from Snowy River led his pony at his head, and he swung his stock whip round and gave a cheer. And he raced them down the mountain like a torrent down a bed, while the others stood and watched in buried fear.
And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand, no better horseman ever held the rein. And not a horse could throw him while the saddle just would stand, he learned to ride while droving on the plain.
Ran single-handed till their sides were white with foam. He followed like a bloodhound on their track, till they halted, cowed and beaten, and he turned their heads for home, and alone and unassisted brought them back. And where around the Overflow the reed beds sweep and sway, to the breezes and the rolling plains are wide. The man from Snowy River is a household word today, and the stockmen tell the story of his ride.
And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand, no better horseman ever held the rein. And not a horse was going while the saddle just did stand, he learned to ride while droving on the plain. And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand, no better horseman ever held the rein. And not a horse was going while the saddle just did stand, he learned to ride while droving on the plain.